everyone, this is Elisa. Welcome back to my channel, Elisa Montreal. This is a bit of a special, I have a pen in my hand. This is a bit of a special video. I'm actually going to put it in between my regular uploaded videos that I upload in this channel every 4 days. So this is in between, and the reason why it's because I got so many requests on the same things, a couple of things, instead of just writing the same answer over and over, the best thing for me to do was to just send everything out into one video so everybody can have the same information at once. Hey guys, that video was filmed exactly 1 year ago, June 3rd. Today we are actually June 2nd, so 364 days ago. It was filmed practically a year ago, and today I am transitioned to this. As you can see from last year's footage, I have white hair that's just around the crown of my head, and the rest is the bleach that I use in order to transition. And the reason why I decided to do this video and show you last year's footage, it's for you ladies, especially those who are just starting and who come to me and they tell me their worries about transitioning and looking ugly. I personally don't think I looked ugly in my transition. I really loved the fact that I bleached my hair so that the demarcation wouldn't be as strong as if I had let it go. I think that if I would have gone, like people love to say, cold turkey, meaning brown and white, yes, I think it would have been so much harder on me. I'm not saying that everybody has to bleach their hair. I'm just saying that knowing my personality, I am so happy I went the bleach route. However, I went about it in a very sensible and calm and patient way. It took me 5 months to finish my 3 balayages that I did in order to pull out as much of the brown hair possible. I went to an excellent colorist who specializes in balayage. Therefore, I knew I was in great safe hands, and that's why I really believe that my bleach was an extreme success. Also, during all this time, I never let go of styling my hair, making sure that it was at its best all the time. I was now a blonde, and it's a color that I've wanted to be all my life. I've always loved the blonde. Of course, you always love what you don't have. Not to say that I didn't like my luscious brown hair, but I've always wanted to be blonde, or at least try it out. And thanks to my white hair, I got to live that for a whole year, and I lived it with the utmost pleasure and absolute success for me to transition, in much of it in total happiness. Today in the street, when I meet girls who still dye their hair and they say to me that they want to transition but they're afraid, I keep referring them to my videos where I talk about this fear and how it could be very distraughting if one's never gone through anything like that. The first thing they say is that they're afraid to look older. Well, I want to talk about that, looking older. Hey, for me, looking older actually made me look sexier, made me look way much cooler than ever, made me look rejuvenated, full of energy, revitalized. So for me, white hair that made me look older actually did the opposite. It was the best thing ever, and it still is, and it's only but gonna get better. 100% of the people I meet in the street, and I mean 100%, they believe that I do this on purpose. No one believes that it's my natural hair. I'm assuming because I have like a lot of brown underneath and I have brown here, maybe people think that it's a balayage, like I purposely do it like that. In any case, 0% people believe that it's my natural hair, 100% believe that it's colored. So much so that I was actually told at one point, sorry, I have some paper at my feet. I was actually told at some point that my hair is so perfect that it looks fake. Man, I could never win. No, what am I saying? I did win. Because we women, we are always striving to be this perfect girl found in magazine and movies, Instagram, YouTube, and we all think that filters will save our lives. Well, for me, going gray, it did that. And my skin, because my scalp is not imbibed with chemicals every 3 weeks, is actually radiating and it's glowing, and it has a natural tinge that is in complete harmony with my gray hair. I know I've said this in other videos, but I'm repeating myself because, like I said, I'm talking about the fact that women, they always say, I fear to look older. Well, like Roxy Foxy would say, if this is looking older, well, bring it on. If you're watching this and you're wondering, will I look older? Well, I am proof that no, you will not look older. But not only I, there's a plethora of girls out there who are letting their gray hair come out, and they really rock their silver hair. And you can see that, you're not gonna look older, baby, at all. This ties into another point that is very interesting and is absolutely the reason why I dyed my hair, and that is the fear of not being dateable. The fear that guys or women might look at us and say, oh God, I wouldn't want to date her because she has white hair. I can understand that fear. However, do you want to be with somebody who doesn't accept you as is? I was in a relationship who didn't accept me as is. That person wanted me to be quiet, or didn't want me to be the spontaneous person that I am. And for him, I played that role for a while. And at the end of the day, or after a couple of years, I finally went into a depression. And it didn't kill me, but it certainly made me so sad that I was not functional. So if I were on the dating scene and I was transitioning, this would actually be the perfect filter to screen out people that wouldn't love me for the way I am. I would actually use that to go on dates. Imagine being with people that are so open-minded, that are so accepting. There are no limits. The world is your oyster. You can do whatever you want. That's the type of people I want in my life. My hair might not be like Anika, beautifully long up to her waist hair, and it's gorgeous. I wish it were like that, but it isn't. It's like this, and I love it like this because that's what's mine. However, I know girls whose hair is short and curly, and it's all this white curly hair. It is just the most gorgeous thing ever. Or I know girls who pixie cut their gray hair very short. Oh my God, I saw this one girl on the bus. I was too shy to ask her to take a picture, but I so wanted to take a picture of her. Absolutely gorgeous. Any millennial would be jealous and give their right arm to have that hair. Every gray hair is perfect. By loving yourself, there is no way that you cannot go out on dates and that the guy or girl could find you the most amazing, sexy person in this world. So 1 year later, this girl tells to this girl, good job, Elisa. You did well, Elisa. You fought the battle. You hung in there. You showed everybody that it could be done. And I am so proud of you. And anybody out there who is scared, it's okay, be scared. If you're not ready, it's okay. It doesn't have to be today. And it doesn't have to be ever. It has to be when you want it, if you want it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you in my next video. Gros bisous.